So let's extend the notion of absolute value of a norm to vectors. Here's a vector. And for the moment, let's say that that vector is real valued and only has two components. So it's a vector in R2. We like to use Roman lowercase letters to denote vectors. So anytime you see a Roman lowercase letter, think vector. This vector here has two components, and since we use lowercase Greek letters for scalars, we're going to denote those components by chi0 and chi1. Okay? And, you know, the way we can visualize this vector in two dimensions is to say, well, let's root it at the origin of our coordinate system. And then we can think of this vector as pointing to the point chi0, chi1. And what does that mean? Well, we have a pretty strong notion of the distance from that point to the origin. You learned about Euclidean distance. That is defined by the square root of chi0 squared plus chi1 squared. So it would make sense to say that the length of this vector is the distance from the origin to that point as measured by Euclidean length. And if you think about it, Euclidean length is only zero if the point to which the vector points is 0, 0, in other words, is the origin. In other words, the vector is the zero vector. Otherwise, that distance is greater than zero. Why? Because the square root of the sum of squares is positive. It's also the case that if you scale the vector, then you merely are stretching the distance proportionally. So the second condition for it to be a norm is met. And finally, we know that if we have a vector x and then we have a vector y and we look at the vector x plus y, then the shortest point between two, sorry, the shortest distance between two points is the direct line, and therefore Euclidean distance satisfies the triangle inequality. Okay. Now, this particular measure of length is denoted by these double lines with two at the bottom, because this is going to be a special case of the P norms, where P is equal to 2. And we can extend it naturally to a vector in N space. By saying, well, if x is the vector chi0 through chi m-1, then its 2 norm is simply the square root of the sum of the squares. All right? And again, you can check that that meets all of these conditions. Now, we sort of said that we're going to mostly deal with complex valued vectors and matrices, and therefore we want to know how to define the two norm for a vector in Cn. And there we need to be a little bit more careful. There we need to take the absolute value of each of the entries, because the entries may be complex valued. And it's going to be an exercise for you to now go and show that this indeed is true. And one thing to keep in mind is that this expression right here is actually also equal to the Hermitian dot product, x Hermitian x, and then taking the square root of that. And the definition of this is exactly that.